baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May God, who has received you by baptism into his church, pour upon you the riches of his grace, that within the company of Christ's pilgrim people, you may daily be renewed by his anointing spirit and come to the inheritance of the saints in glory.
God of grace and life,
in your love, you have given us a place among your people. Keep us faithful to our baptism and prepare us for that glorious day when the whole creation will be made perfect in your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
There is one Lord, there is one faith, there is one baptism. Emily, by the Spirit, we are all baptized into one body. And together, we welcome you into the fellowship of faith.
We are children of the same Heavenly Father. We welcome you.
Thank you that you have claimed us for yourself. Those who have been washed in the waters of rebirth, uphold her in her new life, that she may ever remain steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and rooted in your love, O Father of life. Make known your glory. And so, Jenny is going to present Emily with a candle. On it is the words, the letters Alpha and Omega, Christ, the beginning and the end. If you look at the book of Revelation in chapter 1, you have the fact that God the Father is the Alpha and the Omega. When you get to the end of Revelation, you have that Jesus is the Alpha and Omega. It's one of the reasons that in the Christian church we believe in the Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And we light it from the candle that was lit on the morning of Easter just a few weeks ago.
God has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and has given us a place with the saints of light. You have received the light of Christ. Walk in this light all the days of your life.
Shine as a light in the world to the glory of God the Father.
Thank you. And before we go, and we catch you on behalf of Maloa, our Mother's Union Listens, Observe, Acts is going to present a card.
Before they moved to England, I later came back again to Barcelona. I never knew that today I would stand here to give her, Manoa, Carl as the leader of the group, because I'm a kind of person that shied away. Most time, before the Reverend would say, "Go in peace and serve the Lord," I will carry my bag and go. I run away. But because of the way Reverend John and Reverend David has been running this great family of St. George's Church with their vision, I am privileged to carry this great task. Thank you, Reverend John and Reverend David. So, Emily, on behalf of Manoa St. George's, a very big congratulations to you.
Thank you. Thank you all. When we baptize children, the family normally proceeds around the church, so we can welcome them. And I asked Emily if she wanted to do that, and she said, no, thank you. So that's just acknowledge God's goodness to her and the whole family. It is just lovely to see you all and the blessing that you are to us here and to me as a person. So thank you very much indeed. Let's welcome. Sing a song of a challenge, Shine Jesus, Shine, and then after that the young people and the children will be heading upstairs. I don't promise a short service this morning, so there we are. Let's stand to sing. Thank you. Those of us who remain as we go into another week, we come to confess our sins. We recognize that we have not what we need, what we should need. And therefore, we join together in the words that are in your orders of service. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbor, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that we have passed, and grant that we may serve you. Prayer of the Church for the fourth Sunday of Easter. Let us pray. Risen Christ, faithful shepherd of your Father's sheep, teach us to hear your voice and to follow your command, that all your people may be gathered into one flock to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Now we're going to have a reading from the Acts and from 1 John.
First reading for today is taken from the book of Acts, chapter 4, verses 5 through 12. The next day, the rulers, the elders, and the teachers of the law met in Jerusalem. Annas the high priest was there, and so was Caiaphas, John, Alexander, and others of the high priest's family. They had Peter and John brought before them and began to question them. By what power or what name do you do this? And Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, Rulers and elders of the people, if we are being called to account today for an act of kindness shown to a man who was lame and are being asked how he was healed, then know this, you and all the people of Israel, it is by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, but whom God raised from the dead, and that this man stands before you healed. Jesus is the stone you builders rejected, which has become the cornerstone. Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under the heaven given to man by which we must be saved. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And the second reading is taken from the book of 1 John, chapter 3, verses 16 through 24. This is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers and sisters. If anyone has material possessions and sees a brother or sister in need but has no pity on them, how can the love of God be in that person? Be children, let us not love with words or speech, but with actions and in truth. This is how we know that we belong to the truth, and how we set our hearts at rest in his presence. If our hearts condemn us, we know that God is greater than our hearts, and he knows everything. Dear friends, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence before God and receive from him anything we ask, because we keep his commands and do what pleases him. And this is his command, to believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and to love one another as he commanded us. The one who keeps God's commands lives in him, and he in them. And this is how we know that he lives in us. We know it by the Spirit he gave us. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, Simon. As we prepare to hear the gospel of Christ, we're going to stand and we're going to sing a song, Breathe on Me, Breath of God. It's an old hymn. The word for breathe in the Old Testament is also the word for breathe. word is spirit. So in singing this, we're inviting God as we come to hear the gospel of Christ, just to pour out his spirit upon us, to breathe on us. And it was his breath in the story of creation that we have at the beginning of Genesis that created us male and female, who brought us into the world, who created all that there is. We pray to sing, breathe on me, breath of God. My Father loves me is that I lay down my life only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own accord. I have authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. This command I received from my Father. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please sit down. This building that we have here is owned by something called the Intercontinental Church Society, and we ceased to own it, I think it's in 2030. And every year the Intercontinental Church Society has a conference, normally in Switzerland, where, believe it or not, the cheapest conference center that you find. And 2 mornings ago it was -6 degrees. So Swiss friends gave us some cheese and said, do you have a fridge in your room? We just put it on the balcony and it never got above 2 degrees for the whole week. We went there on Monday and arrived home last night. And we were with chaplains from Addis Ababa, from Izmir in Turkey, from Netherlands, from Germany, from France, from Switzerland, and ourselves from here. It's exciting just to see what God is doing in all different parts of our fellowship. And during this coming year, the head of ICS and their legal person is coming down, and with Josephine and the church wardens and myself, we'll be looking at ensuring our safety beyond 2030. We look forward to meeting with them. These are the greetings. It was exciting to be with Christians from all over the world and here from all over the world this morning. Jenny suggested that we not put up the words, "For the Lord is my shepherd," and we just do out of memory. And I thought, really, it would be a cacophony, because all of us remember in different translations and even different languages. And whereas when I say it by memory, it's not the words that we read this morning. Mine is a mixture of the older translations and the newer. But I just want to say a few words about being the shepherd. During the pandemic, when the back wall of the garden was being painted by Debbie and Jenny and various bubbles, the text on "I am the good shepherd" did not get finished. And for a couple of weeks it said, "I am the good sheep." And then that "she" was, when we go back to doing it, it became "I am the good shepherd." We're not going to have a 20-minute sermon this morning as we normally do, but a few things to get us thinking. The quality of the shepherd is what is important. A few years ago, I told the story of a friend who was a 9-year-old. I went to work in the cattle market in our town. And there was a door missing, a gate missing in one of the areas. And the farmer stupidly said to me as a 9-year-old, "I used to work there and get paid with ice cream," which I thought was great. It's probably illegal to work at that age nowadays, but I loved it. And they said, "Just stop the sheep getting through." And you can guess what happened. One sheep got through, and all of them got through. So they trusted the wrong person. And that's why when we hear the Psalm 23, "The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing," we can say it with confidence, because we know him, the one who said in the gospel reading, "I am the good shepherd." And it's because of the nature of Christ that we can have confidence, because he is the one with power. Someone who sometimes comes to church here or worships in another church sent me a YouTube yesterday of something in the Museum of London, where they're taking one of Rembrandt's paintings of ship on the Galilee, Autumn Galilee, in the midst of the storm, when Jesus comes to the storm. And they've done it as an experience. And in this YouTube, which he filmed, the ship was going up and down. I don't know how they did it. It was as if the waters were coming out and the people were sitting there. And there in the middle was Jesus, initially asleep, because his presence was not all that was important. It was the fact of his power that was important. He was the one who could make the difference, simply because of who he was. And this psalm of Psalm 23 is one of the most important, famous psalms in the world. After I preached this a couple of years ago, I had a book in circulation written by someone who I knew, who's now dead, who was himself a shepherd in the Highlands of Scotland, and talked about the sheep, and he said, "I knew every sheep by name." And a friend of his who was a sheep when he was young sent his sheep off to the next stage in their growth in the lowlands of Scotland. And he was passing in a bus and he looked over and said, "There's my sheep." Now when I see sheep, I see sheep. But he knew them exactly. He said, "I would take care of every sheep. If a sheep was weak, I would bring it to me." He said, "I would take it into the house and care for it." Every single one was important. I am the good shepherd. And as Emily has been baptized and entering into the arms of this one, one in whom she can have absolute confidence. In the reading from Acts, there was a miracle done. "By what power or by what name did you do this?" And Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "The name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth." had an interesting experience this week. There was a couple who were chaplains, assistant chaplains in Lyon, and their two children. One was aged 6, the other 8. The age of one of 6, we were having lunch with them, and I said, my name is John. He said, no. He said, your name is Peter. A 6-year-old to say. And then he kept calling me Peter, Paul Robert, and then he said, your name is Peter. And I thought, Lord, is this you speaking through him? My head for some stormy waters, ready to learn to walk on the water. And then on the last day before we left, he said, your name is John. And then his sister said, no, your name is Peter. And names are important, aren't they? Names have to do with the authority and the power of the one you represent. Any embassy official has no authority in their own mind. Their authority comes from the name they carry. And that's what we have confidence in. And as we go to serve Christ in this coming week, and throughout the rest of our lives, we go with this. The Lord is my shepherd. I am the good shepherd, he says. He leads me. I know my own, and my own know me. Because the challenge is always, do we know him? Is he the one that we know him? I would love to baptize other people next week. I don't care how often I do it. Then if you would love to be baptized and proclaim Christ as your Savior and Lord, come and see me. Because this is the great story that we share. At the confirmation at the beginning of June, we'll be saying that I want to be part of the community of Christ worldwide. And that's the next stage. If any of you would like to be confirmed, I've got forms here with me, and some at the back on the right hand side. This story is too important. His name is above all names. He is the only shepherd that we can absolutely trust. Let's follow him together and individually. Amen. At this point, we normally have the creed, but we have the creed as part of the previous of the baptism service, and we're now going to pray, and I think part of it is leading us in our prayers this morning. And we will sing as we come to prayer, Lord, hear our prayer.
St. George's, Barcelona, and Andorra, and we are blessed that the Reverend Rachel is part of it. Pray for her as she serves while also having a busy family life. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
This morning I rose to the tune, "The King of Love, my shepherd is. His goodness faileth never. I nothing lack if I am his, and he is mine forever." We give thanks and pray for Emily and all her family, Charlie, Susanna, and Andy. And we pray for these youngsters who have joined her in this lovely service, that many of them will be touched by the Lord and follow suit, asking to be baptized and confirmed. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for the work of the Mother's Union, of our group here, and most especially for Kiki in her new role as leader in Europe. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for Janet's memorial service next Saturday at 6 o'clock. We thank you for Janet's life and the example she was to so many of us. We thank you also for Jorge. We thank you for their gifts as artists and all the work they did. We pray that the paintings we have may go to the people who will most appreciate them and help people to choose a painting. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
I'm going to read a prayer from Barnabas. It's about something very sad, about Nigerian students being abducted. Boko Haram terrorists attacked the Nigerian village of Gedam in Yobe State about 2 o'clock in the morning on January the 5th. At least 6 people were killed, including Pastor Luca Lebon and church treasurer Minor Abdullah. Several houses and a church building were burnt down. Many other attacks like this are happening all the time in northern and middle belt Nigeria, where around 45,000 Christians have been killed since 2009. We pray that God will give his children in Nigeria the strength and perseverance to endure. Lord, in your mercy. And so we commit this week ahead to the Lord, asking him to go with us in all that we do, to help us through the difficult times and help us to be aware of so many people who suffer, especially in the wars. We pray for peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for Debbie as she is unwell, that the Lord will heal her. And now in our hearts or aloud, we can pray for others who need the Lord's healing touch at this time. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Dorothy. Please stand if you're able. We are all one in Christ Jesus. We belong to him through faith. Heirs of the promise of the Spirit of peace. Share together in the resurrected Christ as he offers his, as his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And share the peace of Christ with one another.
Is he really?
And we're going to sing during this time a tremendous rendering of Psalm 42 as the deer pants for the water.
Thank you.
for you is that if you're able, we kneel or stand from this side, my left, your right, along here, and the bread and the wine are brought to you. I ask that you don't dip into the wine. We discovered actually that's more unhygienic than drinking. But if you're uncomfortable with that, feel free simply to take the bread. If, however, you simply want to receive a blessing, put your hands over your chest, and it would be my privilege to bless you. All the words you need are in your orders of service. And we come to offer the Holy Holy and to the Lord's Prayer. We will sing them both. And the prayers were written by a former member of this church, the songs, Carolina Pascalini's. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. His dying and rising have set us free from sin and death. And so we gladly thank you with saints and angels, praising you and singing. Supper with his friends, and taking bread he praised him. He broke the bread and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine, and again he praised you and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. And bringing before you the bread of life and the cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ is alive. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people. Gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven, through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. Blessing and honor
and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
Please sit down as we sing together the words that the Lord taught us to pray.
Thank you.
faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
And those assisting, please come forward. I should have said before that we have non-alcoholic wine for those who prefer them, and if you need to require gluten-free bread, then we will stop. Thank you. So we join together in the prayer of the communion. My God, thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out to the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Next week is our annual church meeting. And next Sunday morning I want to use as a time of reflecting on the vision for the next year of the church in the sermon next Sunday. And next week I'll be saying, for example, we're sending Darrell from the council, they've served the term and thank God for them. And we're looking for new council members. We particularly need someone else to be another church warden, which is one of the senior lay roles in the Church of England. And if you're interested, there's a place to sign up at the back there. But all the information is there. To vote, in fact, you need to have filled in one of the electoral roll sheets, which are purple, and you'll see these at the door. One or two notices. In the lounge, you'll see a plastic box, and it's products for humanitarian crisis. And a collection of toothbrushes, toothpaste, shampoo, feminine napkins. That's all we're collecting. But if you could bring them. Jimmy, when is the last day for this? The moment is open ended. So this is a box. If you collect these and bring these into the work of getting. And then for ourselves, mention confirmation. And confirmation takes place on the 2nd of June. And if you have not been confirmed, or if you're a Roman Catholic background and wish to be welcomed into the Church of England, do see me about that. There's forms here for that. And then that same weekend, we're having a retreat for the whole of our cluster or deanery, which is Mallorca, Menorca, Ibiza, Costa Brava, Andorra, and ourselves. And there are three speakers. There is Bishop Allison. There is someone from 24/7 prayer. And there is the European director, or the Canterbury director for Mothers Union. And at that time, Kiki, one of our members, will be consecrated by the bishop as president of Mothers Union for the whole of Europe. Sorry? Commission. Consecrated what you do to bishops. You never know, but the stories in the past have been consecrated what they shouldn't have been. So, there we are. So, there's a form of fallout we can to fill in. They're at the back there. They've been sent out as well, or will be sent out. It would be lovely to see 40 or 50 of our church join us on that day. And all the information on these sheets. There's a form to fill in. It says deadline for booking is Sunday the 28th of April. That is for those who are staying overnight, which probably doesn't prefer, like the majority of our church. But we have accommodation booked at the convent up the road for those who are coming from other places and wish to stay there. And the theme of the weekend is joy is a kingdom of justice and peace. Joy is a kingdom of justice and peace. The rest of the notice I will give out next week, as we're already over time. But if any of you would like to have anything prayed for, if you have anything you want to hand over to God, do come forward and we have prayer ministry at the end of our service at the front. This is a church from which people come from all over the world, and therefore we celebrate birthdays in this church. And does anyone have a birthday from last week or the week to come? Celebrate together. So please put up your hand. Evelyn. Evelyn in the back, yes it is, confess.
Chappie on Tuesday.
Who on Tuesday?
Chappie.
Where are you, Chappie? Yes. So you need to go. Congratulations. Girl?
Friday.
Eliana. Tatiana.
Eliana.
When is yours, Eliana? The 29th. Wow, a week. Anyone else? The Eucharistic? When? The 18th. Let's sing happy birthday to all of you.
Stand as we sing together.
with himself the living bread. May you one in praise and love, and raise you up at the last day, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.